We humans attacked all. We are going to be talking about some of the amazing animals.
And welcome to Paige's Planet.
Life is like. Oh, hi planet protectors and welcome to Paige's Planet. Today we're going to be learning about pollinators. It's okay, Pebble. You don't have to be scared of bees. You have a hard shell for protection. No stinger can get through that. Plus, bees are good guys. They help our world be green and beautiful. Oh, that's the mail. I wonder what we got. Dear Paige, thank you so much for putting on such an informative and entertaining animal experience for our Cub Scout pack. Our children learned so much about reptiles and had a truly great time. We really appreciate your time. Thank you, Pack 10. Oh, look, and they all signed it. How sweet is that? Sounds like a call from a planet protector. Let's head in and see what's going on. Oh, look who it is! It's Planet Protector and Beekeeper Molly! Hi, Molly!
Hi, Paige. It's so good to see you.
Molly, how cool is it that someone your age is keeping bees? What inspired you to start beekeeping?
My mom and also we need more pollinators around here for the plants.
And what has been your favorite thing so far about keeping bees?
Looking how much progress they have made, spotting the queen, and opening the hives.
What advice would you give to kids who are maybe scared of bees?
They're more scared of you than you are of them. And also, when they sting you, they die.
Well, Molly, thank you so much. You look incredible in that awesome bee suit, and it looks like you're doing a fabulous job. You have a wonderful rest of your day, and keep on protecting the planet. Bye, Molly.
Bye, Paige.
Let's go! Whoa! You see, animals like butterflies, bees, moths, hummingbirds, even beetles are pollinators. Pollinators help plants reproduce. You see, different plants need to mix up their pollen to make seeds and fruit and more plants. Plants make brightly colored flowers with sugary nectar to attract hungry pollinators inside. They end up getting all sticky with pollen all over them. And then they go from flower to flower, plant to plant. The pollen gets all mixed up and ta-da! Seeds wrapped up in yummy fruit. A is for beautiful buzzing bumblebee. Buzz on over here and be friends with me. E for eco-friendly families. We need the bees to make our world bright and green. E again for everyone. Don't be too busy to explore. S for super pollinating powers. So thank a bee next time you see a flower. Bees! this beautiful beehive. This is what a wild beehive looks like. Before we check out the bees inside, it looks like we have some bee equipment that we can look at. Number one, look, there's smoke coming out. This is called a smoker, and beekeepers use this to help them calm the bees down. It's just pine needle smoke, and it helps the bees stay nice and calm while you're making sure they have all the resources that they need inside their hive. How cool is that? Oh, wow. I wonder what this is for. I know. I bet this is to help brush the bees off in case you need to look at a frame closer or see how much honey is on it. Very nice. It's very soft and gentle so that it doesn't hurt the bees. Look, a hive tool. Beekeepers use this hive tool to help them open up the hive so that they can see all the bees inside. You see, inside a beehive is very sticky, not just because of the honey, but because the bees make something else called propolis. Propolis helps stick the hive all together. And so when a beekeeper needs to investigate inside their hive, the hive tool helps them to gently take that propolis or unstick that propolis, take it off, so that they can look at the individual frames. And last but not least, a lighter to help them start the smoker. Of course, never play with lighters or fire or smokers without grown-ups helping you. All right. Let's take our hive tool and see what's going on in this beautiful box. Oh boy. I'm being very gentle. I don't want to disturb the bees. Whoa! There are so many bees in here. Come on over, let's take a look. Boy. Now this frame is on the outside edge, so it doesn't have very much on it. But look, you can see how the frame looks when the beekeeper puts it in, and then the bees are starting to build right here. That's their wax that they're starting to build. Let's look at another frame a little bit deeper into the hive and see what we can find. Whoa, look at this. All of these bees are hanging out on this one frame. You can see the wax looks kind of brown. That means it's been there for a while. And if you look closely, some of those cells, and that's what they're called, those little hexagons, because things that are hexagon shaped fit together perfectly. So that's what the bees use. Those little hexagon shapes in there store things for the bees. Sometimes they'll store eggs in them and larvae, baby bees. In this case, I am looking at pollen. Do you see how there's yellow inside of some of the cells? That's pollen in there. Wow. I also see some of the cells with a little bit of honey. And look at all those bees so hard at work, keeping all of the ingredients in those cells safe. I wonder what else we can find. Wow. Now this is cool. In these cells, you can see some white. The white inside some of those cells are baby bees getting ready to hatch. They start out as an egg, and then the babies will grow into a larva, and then eventually they will hatch out of their cell as a full-grown baby bee. How neat! Look at the clump of bees down here. Oh my goodness! Look at that! How beautiful are all these ladies? Amazing! Oh my word, there's a bee hatching right here, right now. I want to try to show you where she is. So if we set this frame down, right there. Do you see her? She's sticking her little head out. That is a bee just hatching out of her cell.
Wow!
Now that we've met the bees, I'm gonna put their hive all back together, just the way it was before. There we go. Here we are. Let's put the lid on and let them go back to their day. Awesome! I had so much fun looking in the beehive. Let's see what other pollinators we can find.
The best parts about learning about pollinators is you can find them right in your own backyard. Come on, let's go explore back here and see what we can find.
I just discovered some of this beautiful orange honeysuckle. This is a native plant to Florida and it's in bloom right now. Normally it feeds pollinators like hummingbirds. I wonder if we can spot a hummingbird around here. That would be so exciting. But I noticed there's some bees. Because these flowers are so long and narrow that only a hummingbird's long beak could fit in there, the bees were having trouble getting inside. Their little fat bodies were just too big. So they came up with a different solution. Look at how clever these girls are. Can you imagine a world without pollinators? I mean, look at these beautiful flowers we get to see and smell. Without pollinators, none of this would be possible. I know that bumblebees love these morning glory flowers. Let's see if we can find one.
Well, I gotta say, Pebble, this was
definitely my most delicious adventure yet. Look,
the bees even let me have a little jar of honey. Do you wanna try some?
Hey, did you know that pollinators are in trouble right now? You see, the chemicals that we put in our yard, like pesticides and herbicides, they can kill pollinators and hurt the important work that they're doing for our planet. So don't put any chemicals in your yard, and maybe the next time you see a bee, don't swat at her. Instead, maybe thank her for the hard work that she's doing to keep our planet green and delicious.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Like, subscribe, and share for more awesome animal content like this. Bye.
Super Planet Protector tip. If you want to help the bees, when you're planting plants in your backyard, try to pick local native species. That supports local pollinators, including bees. A great option is wildflowers.